living organisms are capable of regeneration from bacteria to humans. Some species, such as salamander, however, possess mechanisms that enable them to regenerate whole limbs and parts of their bodies. What about humans? Can we utilize this salamander-like superpower? In humans, this capacity is limited to specific tissues and early stages of life. Simply put, we can't regrow our arms and legs, and have to rely on technology to make robotic prostheses. Nevertheless, a recent study at Harvard University suggests that humans may one day be able to regenerate damaged body parts. The primary reason that drives this claim is that every healing process in the human body revolves around the regeneration of skin cells. For example, if there is a cut or bruise on the skin that isn't too deep, there will be no scar during the healing process. Similarly, it is also possible for humans to regrow the skin on the tip of the fingers if the cells under the nails remain intact. Furthermore, the bones are also capable of knitting themselves back together if the pieces are joined back together through human intervention. Keeping aside everything else, it must be clearly stated that growing back an entire limb after it has been cut off sounds a little strange, and justifiably so. Forming a limb again is much more than intertwining the bones and regenerating the cells of the skin. For a limb to grow back normally, there are a lot of components that must be arranged together, such as the veins, muscles, bones, and blood vessels. If seen from the viewpoint of biological theories, our bodies are gifted with adult stem cells, a variety of undifferentiated cells that, after specializing, can form muscles. But under most circumstances, they remain inactive and thus cannot be employed in the limb regenerating procedure. Additionally, the body can also grow back blood vessels and nerves. But literally growing the entire limb naturally is highly unlikely. Multiple studies have concluded that we are only competent in reproducing the superficial level of the skin, which mostly makes way for the dust collected in a house from the dead skin cells lost every day. Some of the most essential steps that salamanders follow to grow their limbs back are absent in humans. For a limb to grow back, the cells must know where they are exactly placed, like whether they are on the tip of the fingers, elbow, or around the shoulders, because only then they would be able to build the required structures around them in the right order. Both salamanders and humans have certain genes that control this operation, but unfortunately in humans they remain inactive. Regenerative and developmental biologist Michael Levin at the Wyss Institute believes that understanding how tissues and organs encode and propagate anatomical information in electrical signals, for example signals that carry the instructions "build a leg here," it could be possible to one day direct a human body to regrow a limb after injury. According to him, the ability to create and repair specific structures is evolutionarily ancient and highly conserved across the tree of life, and that there is no reason it can't someday be activated in human patients. Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by liking, subscribing, and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.